Wouldn't you just want to automate straight and smooth bowing? So while playing, you can think about other things like intonation, rhythm, and expression, so you can play the music you love beautifully. My name is Lata Brouwer, and in this episode of Violin Lounge TV, I'm going to teach you how to automate straight and smooth bowing so you don't have to think about that. There's already enough to think about while playing the violin. I asked you what you want my videos to be about, and someone said, bowing technique, please. I love that because I'm a bowing technique nerd. Specifically, how to get good enough at bowing so you can concentrate on intonation more and don't have to worry about bad bone sounds while trying to practice a piece. That's exactly it. There is a point where you can do something and it costs you a lot of effort and you can only do it slowly. But there's also a point when something goes very naturally and automatically. You can train yourself to go from one point to another. The best way to do this is to do some exercises before you start working on that piece. Then you already tell your hands what they need to do while you're playing that piece, and it will be much easier. First, grab a pencil and practice those smooth and fluent bowing motions. You can do that by painting in the air and then pretend like you are bowing. Then you can grab your bow and place it in position like it would be when you are bowing at the extreme tip. Hold it with your left hand and then go up the bow with your hand and down again. In this way, your arm will know what straight bowing feels like, because you can practice in a mirror and see when you're bowing straight or not. But then when you're playing a piece, you can't see yourself. So you must remember the feeling of bowing straight and not only what it looks like. Then you can do the boring bowing exercise. It means that you bow with the whole bow, so from the extreme frog to the extreme tip and all the way back. On every string, maybe 4 or 8 times, very slowly in front of the mirror, and see if you can discover irregularities or scratches or whatever goes wrong, that you're not entirely bowing straight, that you have a different sound at the frog and at the tip, all kinds of things, and try to correct them in this seemingly easy exercise. Train your motor skills is to do 5 to 9 times exactly the same thing and do it daily for at least a month. Then you'll really see results in your playing. The exercises were painting with the pencil, holding the bow like it's at a tip, and then feel what straight bowing feels like, and the boring bowing exercise. Now, grab your violin, go practice, and leave a comment below what exercise is most useful to you. Thanks so much for watching and see you in a next video. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss my next lesson. Bye bye!